Can you see me? And welcome to another episode of our Lumpia with a Vengeance Q&A series here on Kumu.
What up, Kumu? And good evening if you're here in the US, and good morning, magandang umaga if you're in the Philippines.
We are the cast and the crew, the talent behind the scenes of what is now an award-winning feature film! Lumpia with a Vengeance! My name is Joy Biscum, and this is
Francis Custodio, and I play James Magsaysay, also known as Moon Moon from the movie Lumpia with a Vengeance and the original movie Lumpia 1.
Yep,
that's me. Jeez, that's so cheesy. My God, I can't believe
that. Memorable like moment in my head.
I know, right? So, yeah. So, Joy, I know you've been on the very first Lumpia, and I know you got to tell me your secret. You have not aged one bit since we've last seen each other from the original
put on
movie.
Your eyeglasses, then, because I just got this hair trying to like color.
What's your secret?
I have no secrets. Eskinol. I'm just kidding. No, I didn't. They still have Eskinol. I've never used Eskinol.
Or what is it called?
That's okay. I'm not judging, but I'm just saying I've never used it. But a bunch of my cousins in the Philippines always had Eskinol. That was
or is it called Ponds? Remember Ponds? Those lotion Ponds, do you know? That's like Philippines. Damn it. No. I guess you don't use it, dang it.
Bro, I was going outside trying to get more dark, okay? I was the dark girl. My mom was like, come inside! You're getting too dark!
Yeah, no. Dude, I used the whitening lotion back when I was growing up. I don't know if you ever did it.
No, I just told you I did. No.
Whitening lotion. Jeez.
Brown is beautiful. No, I never did. I've always been dark, and I've never had a desire to be light. Like right now, I haven't really been outside because of Rona, but when my skin isn't like light, I mean, darker, it just, I don't feel like I'm in my body. So I'm really not in my body right now. But no to skin whitening. But again, no judgment. I'm not judging
no
you.
No judgment.
That's
no,
okay no. That you used it. Your skin
Dang
is
it.
Beautiful.
So on the original.
What was that?
No. Go ahead. No judgment. I'm good with the.
Okay, I gotta ask you, Francis. How does it feel to be in an award-winning film? Because, you know, y'all won an award. We, I keep
we,
getting
we,
a part
we
of this.
We won an award.
It's just my voice, but I, like, yeah.
No, it's freaking amazing. I mean, I don't know what other words to say. The fact that we won the audience award and the fact that there is so many people that is rooting us on and watching the movie, it's such a great, amazing feeling. Just not for me, but the rest of the cast and crew of Lumpia with a Vengeance. But just to let you know, Joy, I know when I watched the debut way back when, you guys won the same award. You guys won the same award.
That's true.
You know, how did that feel when you guys won that award?
Bro, can I just say Hawaii just gives so much love. Like, I love going to Hawaii, and I love the film festival out there because there's just so much, you just feel the love and the energy, and it just feels good to be around like so many like-minded individuals, and just the community, you know, just supports at that time, and they still do, apparently, you know, supporting a movement, supporting like entertainment that like we can specifically relate to, you know.
Yeah, so were you in Hawaii when they show the debut
I think I was. I'll be honest with you. There was a lot of partying around a couple of years in a row of promoting the debut. So it all kind of, and yeah, I was. You know what I was? Yeah, I don't remember much, but I know I had fun.
Well, for real, for sure. I mean, people in Hawaii know how to party, man. That's all I got to say. And I know you were there also for Lumpia 1 when they premiered it there, right?
That's right. Yep.
I wish I was there. And, you know, how was that feeling being there, you know, for the debut and for Lumpia 1?
It was great. I mean, Patricio has been such a big component of the debut and just the support of it. And I've seen him and his growth and even like his relationship with his wife, like, grow, and it's kind of interesting to see, like, I mean, y'all filmed Lumpia, like, what year was that? Because it was way before the debut.
Oh geez, I was 16.
What year was that?
Geez, in the 95 96. Yeah.
Oh snap.
Yeah, it took like what, 7 years for a. Yeah, because I remember. So I was probably 95. I was 16. And then I was running up the hill by the time in Lumpia 1. By the time I got to the hill, I was 22. So
and that's the longest run ever, bro.
I know. And if you watch the film, the first one, I was probably like 30 pounds lighter. And by the time I got to the top, I was like 30 pounds heavier and, you know, a shade darker too. So it feels like I ran to like Jollibee or something, and by the time I got to the top, it was like, what the hell happened to this guy?
There's a Jollibee cart on every like 10 steps. You had to like take that break.
Well, I think that's the crazy part about, you know, Lumpia 1 is just that break that we had for such a long time, and you know, we only filmed during the summer, so you know, things change every time. You know, people have braces and all of a sudden our hairstyle changes, or, you know, we all gain weight and people have kids during that process. So it's
they insane. Had kids?
Kids? Well, yeah.
Okay,
I mean,
cool. That's
hey, no judgment, right? The skin no color, judgment, no judgment. Man. No
it's
judgment.
With your baby, it's all good. I am not judging. No, that's interesting because we actually started filming the debut in 97. And we did reshoots, I think, in, was it 99, Pat? I don't even, oh, wait, I mean, Pat's not even here. It's just me.
So did it just, like, literally?
Okay, yeah, so we filmed in 97, and there were pickup shots 3 years later. So I feel you on that, man. And it's kind of crazy that, you know, people just believe in certain projects and are just so connected to them and have a love for them that, you know, they'll stick with it and show up the moment they need to show up. So yeah, it's kind of crazy. It's kind of crazy because when I was watching your guys' stuff, I mean, I didn't see that. How many years break was it from the initial?
It's about 6-7 years.
That's crazy.
Yeah, and it's not like it's like they're it's not like it's like reshoots like you did. It's like literally shooting parts of it.
Yeah, I know.
You know. So that's the crazy part. But hey, I've seen the debut and there was no like change that occurred for you for sure. You know. So you were pretty consistent. So which is pretty good, you know, unlike me, which is horrible. Horrible.
No. I just think the whole process though, it's like, it's so amazing. And just to be on like, I mean, I don't know what your guys' budget was or how Pat was like funding everything, but you know, to be like guerrilla style, like, you know, like embarking on a storytelling adventure, you know, and to have so many people, like there were so many people in the Vengeance movie that y'all did that were like original cast from the first. So that in itself is, that's amazing. What was that movie? A Boy's Life? What is that? I'm getting that so wrong. One with the kid and he follows him throughout with Ethan Hawke is the Boyhood. Some, yeah, it's like that.
Oh wow, yeah.
But no, you guys were just playing that same era.
No, it's definitely it's insane. I mean, for us, it really just started just, you know, passion for movies. I mean, you know, when Patricio made Luca, even just kind of backing up, I mean, we just started just a bunch of friends just making movies for fun. You know,
you guys were all in the same school together and everything.
No, Pat was like a lot older. You know, so it started off when I came when I was, you know, 9 years old. I came from the Philippines, you know, and I came, I was nine. I could barely speak any English. Patricio is my neighbor, you know, so he's right two doors down, and basically came up to me and my brother and said, hey, you want to make a movie?
He's a creepy older guy.
With glasses.
Whoa, that's crazy.
Like, hey, you want to make a movie? You want to make a movie? Things like that will fly now, but you know, back in the day, you know, I had those friends, you know, just straight from the Philippines, barely spoke any English, and he's like, hey, let's make a movie. But you know, kind of just starting off there with just a few friends, and then where Lumpia One kind of grew, kind of bringing in the family and bringing you in Joy as well, and then expanding to what it is now with Lumpia with a Vengeance. So for you, Joy, can you kind of just tell me, you know, your involvement with, you know, working with creators of Lumpia with a Vengeance, you know, with Patricio, how did you get involved with him and whatnot?
Yeah, so I asked Pat to babysit me.
I'm sorry. Did he film your kid? I'm sorry if he did.
Dude, for real, that's a little sus. Like, you know, your teenage neighbor comes over. Hey.
Yeah.
Hey. You guys want to be in a movie? Come to my house and I'll film you.
Put on this sweater and these sunglasses and
Well, at least it's good that he said put on and not take off, right?
Well, you know, I'm trying to avoid that part. Of course, I had to take something off to put something on, right? So. but no, it was cool. You know, it was really fun, and you know, that's where I really saw, you know, Patricio's true passion in the movie and his brother as well. That's so wait, so how did you kind of get involved with Patricio?
He worked on the debut, and you know, the debut was such a it was a project obviously that holds such a big space in my heart and in my life. But he had asked if I would do the narration for Vengeance, and so he actually came. You know what's so crazy? Because we did initial voice, we did the initial, now I can't even think, what's it called?
Like a voiceover?
Voiceover? Why do I want to say voice work?
It's close enough.
It's really sad that I can't have that off the top of my head, because it's just common knowledge if you're
not Batman
voiceover work. Anyways, so he came over to do initial voiceover work, and then they wanted me to re-record stuff, but it was hard because I couldn't actually go, like, he actually had to come over here and record. I think we recorded my daughter's closet, or was it my closet? You know, it was weird because, you know,
he came out of the closet, so or coming in the closet, whatever.
Well, he oh, there's so many jokes there, but anyway,
I know there's just so many.
the second time around when he wanted more retakes and stuff, it was always hard because, you know, I'm grinding a 9-to-5 job, so always trying to find the right time to get it to him. And if the quality wasn't that great, you know, because I don't have his, like, his goods to record, his mics and stuff. But anyways, it was, yeah, I think it was kind of hard because you don't have the direction that you would have if he was right there, or like, we were via phone, but he couldn't really, I don't know. It was just, I don't know. So it was better when he was there. Yeah. It was more challenging when he wasn't, like, in front of me trying to give me direction. Let's just say. So, and I think the last time he had me do some retakes of the voiceovers, I was kind of sick. So I was like trying to hear like which ones, because you know you could pick and choose.
Batman.
Trying to hear which ones I was like, did he use a sick take on that one?
but hey, you did a really good job on there, and you know that voiceover was
just
legit.
Words, bro.
But hey, whatever it takes. You know how what was interesting that you said though, Joy, is you were saying, you know, kind of juggling both your work and you know your life, and I mean how do you do it? I mean, for someone like yourself as an actress, and I mean, how are you able to do that? I mean, that must
well,
be.
So here's the thing. I had kids and, you know, there's like everybody's path is different, man. I knew I wanted to do two things. I wanted to be on TV and I wanted to be a mom. And as I got closer to being like 30, like one started becoming more important than the other. You know what I mean? And so the only thing I really wanted for such a long time was, you know, I want to act. I need to act. I need to do this, you know? Mm-hmm. And for the first time, it was like, I need to be a mom. I need to like have babies. It was weird, you know, when people say like this biological clock, like I never really believed it until I was like almost 30. It was weird. And I was just really blessed and lucky to have had my husband, boyfriend at the time in my life. And you know, it was, and he's an actor too. And so we are very much, you know, the life of an actor, and it has its ups and downs. It's feast or famine a lot. Mm-hmm. When I had my first kid, it just, a lot of things changed. And so it was the first time I had to get like a friggin' 9-to-5 job.
Yeah.
Like consistent, you know, I have a mortgage, I got this baby, you know, and I still auditioned, but it just wasn't, I don't want to say it wasn't as important, because I love, you know, I just love even being in an acting class and like doing scenes, putting up scenes with a scene partner, like I love that. But it just, there's like that fire that I know you need, and yeah. And I know that it wasn't that fire, like, yeah. But I still act, don't get me wrong, like I still go out, I still audition, but it's just, it's, I don't know, you know, I had two kids, and so like just priority shifted for me. I know not for everybody, like a lot of women like are able to like juggle both and still go head into it, and but for me, like straight up, like my body never came, it never snapped back.
Even if you push it back.
Y'all, or your body snapped back.
Or push it back.
Not judging it.
No judgment, no judgment.
Very jealous, actually. But my jealousy comes out as hate. But it's not really hate, it's love. Because
yeah. So how old are your kids, Joy? How old are your kids right now?
My son, his name is Bisco.
Nice.
I did that.
That's a sick name, dude. That's a sick name.
I know, it just came, it's just like, that sounds like a cool name. Oh, that's my name, okay. and it's so funny because it always messes people up. We just traveled, and then the TSA officer or the guy checking, you know, your tickets is like, oh, can I get your ticket? And I was like, oh, here it is. And they're like, no, I already checked this one. And I'm like, oh, no. And he's like, yeah, I saw Bisco already. I'm all, oh, that's my son. And he's like, huh? And I'm like, yeah, if you look, that's his first name is my last name.
So, I like that name. That name is sick.
Yeah. So it was really cool. My husband was really like, he was such a gem. He's so sweet. And you know, I asked if we have a boy, can we name him Bisco? You know, because there's no other boys amongst my siblings, you know. Mm-hmm. So he was just like, yeah, so my son is Bisco Jean-Marie. He is 9 years old, going on 10. We're going to go paintball on his in his birthday next month.
Nice.
2 digits. And then I have a daughter. Oh, she's the sweetest thing. Her name is Zaya. And she is 5. And she just did a commercial with her, with my husband for Walmart. So if you see this little girl barbecuing in a Walmart commercial, that's my Zaya.
That's sick. Right.
Yeah. How about you, kids? Kids?
I do. I have three. Well, first of all, I want to mention about your son's name, Bisco. I think it's genius. The reason I say that is, you know, some of the issues that, you know, women have is like, hey, my name, once, you know, if, you know, once I get married, you know, I take over my, you know,
husband's name.
Mm-hmm. But the fact that you know, your name continues on through your son, which I think is freaking genius, you know what I say?
Yeah.
Which is awesome. I actually have three kids. I have an 18 years old. I have a 13 and I have a 7. We spread that out. So it's kind of crazy. But I think the great part about it is, you know, I my son was actually part of Lupia with a Vengeance, and so is my daughter. And so my son, how old was he? He's probably.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. Yeah, he was one of the kids that died. I think he was, you know, surrounded with a bunch of kids, and then the Lupia was stuffed inside his mouth. And and you know, I think that was filmed a couple of years ago. So when you watch that, you know how kids are, they're like, no, my hair, it looks horrible. Ah! It goes crazy. And then, you know, and my daughter was there too. So the best part about it is they were there when we were filming. So it's kind of fun to have your family kind of watch you do it. So it's such a different experience. So yeah, so the whole fam will be going out and watching the movie again, you know, in a week. So it's cool. But you're right. I mean, there's just so much and there's a lot to do, and it's crazy having kids. It does, priorities definitely
changes it. Cause you are like, you know, like to be, well, I don't know. Did you ever pursue acting after the original? Was that something that was on your butt, like your list of things to do, or was it like a calling, or was it like, I mean, what was that to you after the first Lumpia happened? Like, where did you decide?
Yeah, my calling is called Patricio. When he calls me, that's when I go there. That's pretty much my calling. I took a different direction. I mean, you know, no doubt I do enjoy acting. You know, I've been doing it ever since I was straight from the Philippines, and, you know, Patricio asked me to act. You know, I enjoy it, and it's kind of my creative release in terms of doing something different. I mean, based on my profession, I mean, right now I'm a partner in a CPA firm. So for me, it's a little bit more.
That's a real job, homie.
It is a real job, but it's, you know, for me to be really creative, you know, basically I can go to jail. So you know, there's a little bit limitation on the type of creativity, which, you know, to be able to do something outside of, you know, tax law and tax preparation and do something different, like making a movie, it's amazing. You know, it's an experience I could never change. I mean, a good story would be, you know, I mean, for many CPAs out there, we're kind of boxed in with a different type of, you know, we're seen as, you know, kind of square and, you know, really to the book. And, you know, the fact that I'm able to do something creative, like acting and kind of do something fun like this, it's really takes us out of that element. You know what I mean? So
that's dope, man.
Yeah. So I give props for those, like, you know, attorneys and, you know, other CPAs who does something fun on the side that it's outside of what their normal day job is. So which is great. So.
Kind of like Kim Kardashian, right?
Well, meaning she's becoming a lawyer, but going the other way, right? So I don't know. I don't know what she's trying to prove there. I don't know what she's trying to prove there. You know what I mean?
Hey, man. Yeah. No judgment, man. She can use the skin all if she wants to, too.
do what she needs to do, you know, do whatever works for her, you know? So for you, Joy, in terms of kind of, you know, for those who wants to, like, for example, for me, if I want to pursue acting and I want to get an agent or a manager, how do I do that? And what are my options? And, you know, if that's a route that I want to choose to do.
Well, it's just funny because I am the last person in the world that is probably still on MySpace or Friendster.
I can't believe that.
I'm not technically. No. So here's the thing. The whole industry has evolved, and I could talk about this for days, because the media, how it is now, I'm so analog, right? And so there's all, I don't have social media. I have a Facebook, but that's so I can play my gambling game, I have to say. Actually, if you do look me up on Facebook, I have a picture of my son when he was born. And
that's probably your only...
the really last time when I've really gone on it. And so I don't have Instagram. I don't have Twitter. I don't have Twitter. I don't have anything. Snapchat. I don't know what. I'm not. If you do see me, then it's not me, because it's not me. I don't know. I'm not. So to answer your question, that was so off. But I don't know, because the industry has so evolved now. I don't know if it's the same as how, like, when I came in. I came in like in the 90s, bro. Like 91, I think, is when I booked my first thing. And so it's been a minute. And so, like I said, I tap in and out, and I'm really lucky to have my agents that have been with, and they, you know, like, it's hard to be, I don't want to do that, you know, or mm-hmm. when you know, they're pushing for you, they're your agents, are representing you. I know how it used to be. It would kind of depend. I mean, there's so many different ways. There's no rule. The thing about the entertainment industry, there's no rule. Like, every rule gets broke. So you can, you know, be discovered just walking. And now with social media, people will discover you on the little things that people do or create. You know, you YouTubers, like all these little kids that make so much money. It's crazy.
It's insane.
I wish, actually, this technology was available when I was, I would have had a desire to learn it. I where I'm at now, I really don't care I don't care to learn new things. I just, you know, I know what it is to show up in an audition and try and do my job, like to mm-hmm. try to get the part. And then I have my 9-to-5, and I work at a biopharmacy company. So it's so different, you know, from like rewind 10 years ago, even, you know, my life is just so different after I had my kids.
So,
and it's a great thing. It's like, what was that?
So was it worth it getting an agent? Or I guess you're saying,
you need an agent. Yes. You're going to need an agent. There's just different ways about how to get it. The idea is they like you based off of whatever reason, like they have you come in and they interview you, or they have you read, or you can do showcases and like pick up an agent through that. There's no rule on how to. You just, if you want it, you'll find a way.
Yeah,
you
know? Yeah.
And then you work your way to like a better agency, I guess, or, you know, as you build your resume. So yeah, it just, you know, it's a lot of hard work, you know, and people do it, and, you know, it's peaks and bows. Like, it just depends, man. Like, the industry is not for the faint-hearted.
No, true. But like you said, it's like, you know, famine or feast or famine. It's just kind of just how the industry works. And I think if you're not patient, it makes it a little bit difficult to get what you want. You know, it's pretty crazy, you know, how things all work that way.
Well, how did it feel to be on set of the new movie? Were you able to request vacation time for the work, or did you have to use your sick sick days?
Well,
oh, wait, don't lie. Wait, no, but you might have to lie. See, this is a hard one. This is a question. And you know, you're a partner in a firm, so I don't know if you should answer that. Patricia, put that question up.
I just leave, I like, peace. I'm going, no, I mean, it's, it definitely, I think it was a lot of work to do it. So initially, when Patrick actually, Patricio actually initially posed,
the idea,
gave me the idea of making Lupia with a Vengeance, you know, I think I was the hardest one to convince, you know.
Oh, really?
Yeah, part of it, I was telling him, you know, hey, you know, I think back in, you know, when was it 16 or 17 when he, you know, brought it up, I'm like, hey, man, you know, I, you know, just meet partner in the firm. I was still going, getting my master's degree at that time. I'm coaching basketball and baseball for my son and, you know, with three kids. I was like, this, you know, this is too much, you know. And yeah. I really love what I do. I love being, doing tax for my firm and, you know, kind of the clientele and all that. That's and cool. I don't really know whether I can really put the time into making the movie. And the initial script for Lupia with a Vengeance, to be honest, it's all revolved around my character Moon Moon. So then when I saw it, I'm like, and I know how much work it takes to do a movie. I mean, filming just a few minutes, you know, could take a day, a whole day, you know? Mm-hmm. So I was aware of that. So I told Patricia, I'm like, hey, let me think about it. You know, there's just so much going on and, you know, but, you know, I think after a discussion, I told him, hey, maybe shift it to, instead of being my character, being the main character on the film, maybe shift it to my son. I think initially I had a son, and then eventually I think it was a good move by the producers and Patricio to make it a daughter, which brought up Rachel, my daughter's name, but it's April Absent, so she did a really great job. And
she was great. She was so cute. Oh my God, I'm such a fan. She was, and I was like, does that work? Can you have a high school daughter right now? But I guess in real life you do. So hey, what do I know?
Yeah, I guess it works, right? Yeah, no. So it worked out well. And I mean, she carried the movie for sure. I mean, her acting skills is amazing. Mm-hmm. You know, and that's something I definitely cannot bring into the film. It's fun. I mean, definitely, but it wasn't my forte. So it's being in the film itself, just to answer your question, it's definitely different from what we did from Lumpia 1. You know, when we started with Lumpia 1, you probably remember Joy is, you know, it's a regular camcorder with using a boom mic as a hockey stick. And, you know, we have a script that's never, we had a, you know, script, but no one really, Patricio never followed it, so useless, right? No offense, Patricio, but with the second one, it's so different. You know, it's actually now professional actors, and now you got, you know, instead of just you and Patricio doing the filming, now you have 50 other people there, and it's just so intimidating, but, you know, definitely an experience I will never forget. I'm glad I still agreed to do it despite the craziness in my life.
It was refreshing to see just like that, you know, the unit of the original, to see so many of the original people still in it. Like, that was great. That I thoroughly enjoyed that. And that's interesting that you said it you actually suggested the shift to your child, and it does make a good, that's a great suggestion. Is he paying you? Could you like literally just like flip that movie? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well, it was actually
screenwriter credits. Right there.
It was April that paid me. So hey, make it the daughter, and we'll go from there. But yeah, no. It's, you know, I think part of it is just time to do it. And, you know, like you said, you know, priorities does change.
You know what's so funny? I was up for this really good this really good part for this show. And had I booked it, it would have been a regular recurring. So kind of like a series regular. And then I started thinking like, oh God, what if I get it? And then like, I'm gonna have to choose, like, cause then I'm gonna have to lie about like stuff, like, you know, like I'm sick today, you know. Yeah. I don't know how many sick days I can really like play off. So it just became like kind of like a like, you know, you play it in your head, like, what's my chess move? You know what I mean? What's the end game? And ultimately, like, I just drove myself crazy and I ended up not getting it, so that made it a lot easier choice because I had no choice. But the idea of it, dude, I was so anxious. It gave me so much anxiety because it's just like I have this great job and it's, and I enjoy it. And then there's this part of me that will always be a part of me that I enjoy and that I love. And then I say bye to my stability.
Yeah.
No, again, like go back in full, like, cause then I got to really jump. If I'm gonna commit, I'm gonna have to commit. You know what I mean? Like right now I edge between both, you know? But yeah, it's kind of crazy. Although, you know, there's time, like I did, like a few years ago, I did this movie randomly, like, cause I pretty much stopped auditioning for a while cause I didn't want to do it. Like I just wasn't in the right headspace and like, it just didn't feel right. And then my body just, it's like as an actress or as you grow older, you like, you know, your body changes, like, you know, you get older. And there was a lot of things like, you know, I was trying to like figure, because my whole life, even in my late 20s, you know, I was still going out for stuff where I was like high school, like early, you know, like I still looked young. And then fast forward, like now I'm like a mom, or even like it just things that I didn't think, like I'm a mom, even though I wasn't one in real life, but then a mom to like a high school kid, that was bananas to me. Cause I was like, am I that old? And then cause in my mind, I'm still like this version of me, which I'm not, but like in my mind, in my mind, like I can still like, you know, kick it.
Yeah.
With the youngsters, and I probably can't. And then my son would probably say I'm super cringy right now.
Oh, that's what I want to say. I think anything that you do, even though you feel that you're a cool parent, they think you're cringy all the time. And like, there's not, even if I'm in this movie, there's nothing I can do to be cool in front of my kids' eyes. So it's kind of crazy. But like you said, you know, I mean, I think taking on that role, you know, working your 9-to-5 job, taking on that role, and then, I mean, something has to give, right, Joy? So either you're going to be your family, your job. And, you know, one thing I've learned is, you know, time really flies by. I mean, I can't believe my son's already, you know, going to college, and, you know, things just like that just flew by. And, you know, it's just amazing that at least I was able to spend a lot of time with my kids and see them grow. And that's something you can't ever take back. But with that said, though, what if they do, you know, a debut sequel? Is that something, a project that you would take on, you know? Would you pass that on to your daughter, you know? Yeah. Like what I did for Lupio with Invention?
So the debut, that kind of centers around like the Bernadette and Dante's family. I mean, I think that they kind of talked about like the idea of something like that. Oh, sorry, like I gotta plug in my computer, it's about to die. Because I am not smart and I didn't do this earlier. But I would. Yeah, I totally would. I would want to. But then again, it becomes like, oh, where are they filming and for how long are they filming? Like those are things you gotta juggle and like be real about stuff with. I mean, I guess I could actually ask my workspace to take time off. Like a long, like X amount of vacation, but you know, I don't know. It's one of those things. Cause I am no longer like just both feet hitting the ground, just pursuing this one thing that I love, because now I have a family, you know, I got a mortgage. I got like adulting to do, and you know, adulting kind of sucks. But, you know, if I don't adult, then, you know, who's going to, until my kids get to Ryan level.
Yeah.
I'm trying to pimp my kids out too. I'm always saying, YouTube channel, guys. Come on, you know, mommy doesn't have to work. If you really do a YouTube channel.
Got to have them blog in, right? Yeah, I mean, but if you do debut the sequel, I mean, I love the movie that you did. One, you have to do that dance off again. I thought that was that was great. I think I tried to replicate that early on, and I mean, just to be clear, I'm doing the guys dance.
Okay, I was dance. Like, oh, I can see you do like the booty roll. Okay,
just to be clear, no. and then the second one you have to do is that hand thing that you and Dante did. That
the infamous. Then you close in. Oh yes,
that was such a sick move. You know.
See, you know what's so crazy? Like I talk about this, it's so many panels or like so many interviews, but like my hands are like I have long fingers. So any dude that wants to play, like you got to come with it because mama got like long hair. But no, it was, yeah, if I would, like I said, to go back, like I would love to be a part of that because the debut was just such a great, like, and you know, like around that time, there was such a good, God, community, you know, mm-hmm. sense of community around that time, because Lumpia was around, you know, around that time too, right? So it's just so cool to see that, or to have felt that. So I would not change that for the world at all mm-hmm. with it. And you know, if the moment comes, and the moment comes, like I said, when I stopped going out for a while, and then randomly my agent's like, pitch this, how about this thing? And I'm like, I'll do it. And then I find out it's a Denzel movie, and then I end up booking it. So I have a scene. I didn't do nothing for a while, and then I have a scene with Denzel. It's just me and Denzel. And it just like kind of blew my mind. I was like, because that's my husband's favorite actor too, you know? And it's just like, he's like, dude, you don't do anything, and then the first thing when you come back, you book a fucking movie with Denzel.
Dude, that's sick.
But the scene got, I was so sad because, like, you know, it was a scene, just me and him. I was a nurse, of course. Of course. Gotta keep it real. it was a nice little scene just between me and him, and then it ended up getting cut out of the movie. But it was just really cool he definitely has a presence. It was such an honor to just even like work. And did it was a feel, different kind of work. What was that?
Did you feel any, were you intimidated in any way that you're like, oh shit, I'm going to be filming with Denzel Washington? You know, how crazy is that?
Here's the thing, because I stepped away from it. And so now even when I go out, it's different for me. The audition process is a little different. I don't hold it so, I don't hang on to it. You know, a lot of times actors obsess after they leave an audition, like, oh, I freaking should have said this, right? Oh God, why didn't I do it this way? Or like, oh man, I didn't, you know, like literally, I mean, and some actors probably are able to let it go. I was not one of those actors.
Yeah,
I would obsess if I just really felt, I either like freaking nailed that or like, oh my God, what the fuck did I do? You know? and now it's more so like, I'm just chilling, dude. I'm me. I'm just okay with, there's no desperation to like book something.
Yeah.
Like I don't have that need that like, you know? And it feels freeing. It's very freeing, actually, and I enjoy it more.
I think just in age in general, I think that as you start growing and maturing, I think you have that sense where you're like, yeah, I don't really need that as much.
Like that grumpy old man.
True. Yeah. No. I mean, I mean, you know, you were amazing in, you know, the debut. You were great in, you know, Lumpia as the, you know, the karaoke queen. But I mean, I would have to say, Joy, my favorite character you ever played was Melanie in The Journey, you know, for Patricio's wedding. Dude, you did an amazing job on that. And, you know, I mean, the casting was
the sweetest, like, energy I could try to find within my like, sordid, filthy soul. I had to just find the, like... Because she's so sweet. Mel, Patricio's wife, if you guys don't know, that's Mel.
Yeah, I know. I've known Mel for a long time.
Yeah, and she's the sweetest. So I just had to think like cupcakes and sunshine.
Hey, whatever motivation gets you to get there, you know what I mean? It's great. Yeah, I think the overall you know, the casting of that of the journey was great, with, you know, Dariel for, you know, for,
oh yeah,
casting for AJ, you know, with and as well as with Dar. But I don't know about the casting of Dante Bosco for Patricio. That's a little bit of a stretch, don't you think? Come on. Dante Bosco, Patricio, I don't know. But overall, man, you know, I think when that the journey, and when he premiered at his wedding, man, I gotta say, I teared up. You know, especially at least at the part when they started, you know, doing the slideshow mm-hmm. and all that, and then Patricio and Melanie stood up, and I was tearing up, and then until I saw Patricio dance, then my tears stopped. So
that's so sweet.
But it was good. That was such a great,
it was cool too. Yeah, because they also had Krish. I don't know if you know Krish, Krish and Joan. There you go. Okay. So Rocky Rivera is, she was in that too. And she, her and Bam, mm-hmm. There together. And then Bam, my husband, Philip, used to, do performances with Bamboo Jonah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So Joy, I know one of the special, you know, thing that I know about you is that you're married to a Power Ranger. So is it being married to a Power Ranger? And does he get a lot of bonus points from your son for being a Power Ranger?
To be honest, no. we tried to make them watch like his season. They don't care. It's so funny. But my daughter, like, bless her soul, Zaya, hold on, Bisco.
Yeah,
can you go get daddy? Can you get the thing in your room of daddy? Go get the thing in your room of daddy. Go up. He's playing Call of Duty. The kids don't really care. I think they really don't care that we, like, you know, the Not Another Teen Movie was on, and they kind of watch, you know, there's a lot of parts that they can't watch.
Yeah.
But, you know, I'm like, look at mommy was skinny. Look, see that? Look. You know, and it's like, look what you guys did to me. And then my daughter plays with my belly and stuff. But this is my husband.
Dude, how cool is that, you know?
That's your... I'm Joy's husband, Philip Jean-Marie.
Does he still have his original Power Ranger costume?
He does. No, that was like a Japanese little Asian person in there. No, he had his own, but they did minimal stunts, but they have, you know, with Power Rangers, it's a whole stunt team. Funny thing is, really quick story, like, Power Rangers was very much a big part of, like, my story in the beginning of when I started acting, because mm-hmm. I literally was, after the first original cast, you know, they decided to do this thing of, you know, casting a new squad every year, right?
Yeah.
And so literally every year thereafter, I was pretty much always up in the running for one of the spots for the Ranger.
Really?
Yes.
You could have been the Yellow Ranger. How cool is that if you were there with your husband?
It's so crazy. But like, what's funny is he ends up, like, fast forward, I meet him at a show I'm hosting. I'm like emceeing an event in San Diego, and he was performing in this group with Bamboo, and that's how I first met him. And then maybe a year or so later, I met him randomly, like at a spot in Hollywood, and we just started, like, he made me laugh. He's such a funny guy. I love him so much. But yeah, he's my actor. He's the actor. So actually, my daughter, she booked her commercial. It's a Walmart commercial, but it was because they need, like, especially during pandemic, they've been doing a lot of, like, family stuff, right? Mm-hmm. So with that, it was like a father-daughter thing. So it was really cool, and I was worried, you know, if she may not like it, you know, but the cool thing about when she booked it, I've actually booked a lot of series regular pilots that never got picked up. Yeah. So that feeling of like when you book something and you're like, like, oh God, you know, when I found out that Zaya and Philip booked that Walmart commercial together, it was like 10 times the feeling like if I booked something. So then I knew, like, you know, I'm okay with like stepping in and out of it. When I went on set, that was a whole other world. It was so cool to like not be the talent, you know, but I'm the mom of the talent. It was it was crazy. It was cool.
Yeah, no, I think the just in terms of just the achievement itself, I think it's like 10 times as if it's yours. If it's yours, it's fine, but if it's your kids, I mean, it's like it felt like, oh my God, it's times 10, right? It's amazing. And I'm sure your daughter is going to be amazing in it. You know, she has the acting genes from both the mom and the dad. So it's natural. It's a natural path.
I just wanted her to, like, you know, enjoy it. You know, because with kids, they're kind of funny, right? Because they could be so, you know, gregarious and show up, but then in front of a casting director or when camera starts, then they may just like, I don't want to do this, or just like get shy. So I was really worried. So I had my bribery gift with me just in case she was like pulling a like shy moment, but she didn't. And I didn't need to use a bribery gift until later when she was getting tired. I was like,
got
a gift. Come on, we only have a few more takes. Okay. A few more takes.
Nice. Hey, do what you gotta do, you know.
Right. Wait, so now there's a Lumbia comic book and new issue comes out this week. How does it feel to be illustrated in a comic? Because that's like, you know, forever, ever. I mean, not that film isn't forever, ever, but like comics. And I just love the through storyline that how Patricia's always used the graphics of like comic book storytelling into his movies. How does it feel to like see that?
No, I think it's the coolest thing ever. You know what I mean? Because for me growing up, I collected comics. I mean, Patricio and Dario, they're a big influence, you know, on me, my brother, and, you know, the rest of people in the neighborhood kind of growing up. I mean, Patricio was into collecting comics and so kind of passed on to us. So collecting comics
He passed that on to you guys?
No, I wish he passed on his actual comics to me, but he didn't. He gave me the shitty
one. Was he
passing
that on while he was filming you guys?
Here you go. Take off that sweater.
Read the comics. Wear this sweatshirt, but take off that first and let me film you.
Here, Silver Surfer number one, and this will make it worth it. It's like that thing that you give your daughter, but then this is the comic book was what Patricia gives us. But just in reality, it's just an honor, I would say, to be part of illustrated by, you know, big names of comic book artists. And, you know, to be honest, it's actually sitting in my office. So,
ooh, I want to see.
Well, here's one of them. I change it on a daily basis. So, like, I have a whole box. So I change it every week on a new comic book, and I put it on my ledge. So it's for this week is this one. So
hold up. I got the perfect.
Hey, is that from the debut? Did you get that from the debut? Because that was there for sure.
You know what's so funny?
There it is.
It's when I moved out, when I moved to college up here in LA. And I moved to my first apartment with my buddy David Cruz. What's up? our apartment literally was like nothing. I'm like, I'm gonna go steal stuff from my parents' house. And I took the wooden fork and spoon, but it's been, I thought I lost it. And then I was going through some stuff and I was like, oh snap, I have the wooden fork and spoon.
Wait, the question is that up on your dining room, just like any other Filipino family, or is it just there?
I just found it. So that's why it was crazy, because like when I was watching the movie, I was like, oh, It's a reason. There's a reason for everything. Like, there is. There's a reason. I don't know what the reason, but there's a reason. You know? Anyways.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's awesome, man. I wish I have that too. You know, and every Filipino family have to have those pork and spoon.
Let me ask you, because you lived in the Philippines, do they have that in the Philippines, or is that like an American, Filipino-American like kind of thing?
No, they do. They do. I mean, okay. First of all, you have to have the Last Supper.
That's, oh, of course.
That's for sure. Yes. And yes. Then right below it is the pork and spoon. You know, it's just a normal one.
Let me ask you this. So is the Last Supper, is it a rug?
What? No, I think that one goes on.
What am I? No, listen,
no, it has to be. It has to be the car one.
See, there's a rug. Cause I was like, there's the one where it's, you know, framed. But I remember like in multiple houses there was like the big rug that it's on the wall.
Really?
Yeah, I'm knowing, man. If you know, type in right now, chitty chat, bang bang. You know, I don't know how to do this stuff, but you know, type in. On the Kumu, is that right? I don't even know if I'm saying that right.
Yeah,
had that Last Supper as a rug or as a frame.
Or the actual like carvings. That's the one we have, like where they carve it out of wood and the actual, you know, disciples that are sitting on the table, which is like.
Oh, so you fancy, green. Huh?
I guess. I guess.
you one of those Filipinos in the Philippines with money, huh?
our forks and spoons are actual metals, and it's not wooden. So just let you know.
That ain't keeping it real. What? Oh, see.
But Joy, I know you were saying about, you know, hey,
silver spoon stuff. What?
Did you see have you seen the Instagram filter that came out this weekend for Lumpia with a Vengeance? Have you seen it?
Bro, I am not. I'm the most analog kid in the world. I don't have Instagram. I told you. Oh wait, no, I did see it because you showed it to me earlier.
Well,
I don't have Instagram, but I don't mess with social media. I'm very analog. I still type on a typewriter. I don't type on a typewriter, but in my mind, that's what I do, and I type like this too.
Oh man. Here, let me demo it for you. Let me do it real quick. And then I'll show you what it, this is pretty crazy. Innovative, it's definitely innovative.
What are you doing? But, I can't see your face.
I gotta show you the actual.
Oh.
That's sick, right? I don't know, I mean, I swear, AJ and Patricio, they just come up with these amazing, you know, innovative Instagram stuff that just, you know, blows my mind, you know, so it's definitely out of my element being a CPA, so, you know, but I agree with you, sometimes I type like this, sometimes it's faster too, so.
You lie, no you don't.
Okay, yeah, I'm lying. There's no way I'm gonna survive tax season if I,
Well, you do, well, right. What is that called, because you're only on the calculator thing, right, you're like,
oh man, that's old school, the 10 key. It's called a 10 key. Yeah. But
you don't do that anymore?
I do, but I don't have the actual machine anymore. That's cool for CPAs. That's like really old school. So,
but it could be keeping it real.
I'm
just saying, you know, throwback, you know, there's a lot of people trying to bring like overalls and like hot top fades and stuff. So, you know, you might want to bring a Rolodex back, you know. Yeah, geez. Yeah. You know what's so funny? One of my coworkers, you know, Rolodex, she's like, what's that? I'm like, you don't know what the Rolodex is. Oh my God, I'm so old.
Or those phones when you tell your kids that, you know, that twirls around, you know. So it's
the what?
You know, those phones where it's
like, yes. Yeah, the rotary ones.
The rotary phones. And they're like, what is that? You know, how do you even use this? So you got to bring that back too. So, Joy, we're getting close to finishing it. I mean, it's been freaking amazing talking to you, but then let's do a quick nerd round. And let's talk about like tax pop culture. So it's just going to be rapid fire. And the first thing that comes up in your mind, just tell me. All right.
Okay.
All right. No pressure. No pressure. All right. Ready? Yeah.
Okay.
Here we go.
You're going to ask me?
I'll ask you.
Okay.
Or unless you want to take turns or.
On the same thing? On the same question?
Sure. That's fine. Yeah. Sure.
Okay.
What's your favorite comic book character?
Wonder Woman.
There you go.
Your favorite comic book character?
Spider-Man, because he's married to MJ and my wife's name is MJ. So.
Aww. Just fits. That's so sweet. Okay, favorite TV series that you are binge watching right now?
The Warrior in HBO Max. It's the one that Bruce Lee wrote. It's sick. Favorite TV series? How about you? Favorite TV series that you're binge watching now? Except your own movies or shows.
That's not a thing. We wouldn't binge very far, okay? Let's just keep it real, bro. There's only so many times you'll be able to listen to me narrate Lumpia, okay?
No. Or you can rerun the same karaoke scene over and over.
Umbrella Academy.
Awesome. Favorite movie of all time?
Ooh, can I have a few? I love What's Eating Gilbert Grape. I like Memento. Shawshank. Ooh. Who doesn't love Shawshank?
Oh, Shawshank's the best.
Okay, you, right back at you. Favorite movie of all time.
Any Adam Sandler movies. I'm just amazing. I love all his movies. And I don't know, for some reason, I've always loved License to Drive. With the Coreys.
The Coreys, man. The Coreys. I had the hugest crush on Corey Haim. Oh, rest in peace.
Yeah, no, I feel that way. So my son's starting to drive. So I feel like that License to Drive thing.
Oh, how funny.
Favorite autograph item you own? Do you have any?
My husband writing me a check. I don't know.
That's the best autograph ever.
How about you? What's the best autograph?
I would say Will Clark, because just to make Patricio jealous, because he's a big Will Clark fan, and I met him and he didn't, so sorry. But Will Clark is a baseball fan.
Okay. So. Favorite celebrity that you've ever met?
Joy Bisco.
Oh,
I don't know if you know. I don't know if you remember. We met each other. You know that, right? Do you remember?
We met each other. Did my friend Jeanette introduce herself to you?
Oh my God. Well, unforgettable face, obviously. But we met at the Tower Records when the debut came out.
In up there.
Tower Records.
Yeah. Okay. No, I do.
Are you just pretending? Are you just saying yeah?
No, because Patricio was with you.
Was he though? Was he though? So, I think you're just. But yeah. But I have a picture of us. So just to throw it out there, and.
Speed motion that, Pat.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
All right. Well, who's your favorite celebrity you've met for you?
My husband. No, actually, that Denzel, because. But I've said this before. If you've ever been on a panel and I talked about inspiration, meeting Dante and actually working with him, because he was an inspiration, and Didi Magno, she's from San Diego, my hood, and she was on the Mickey Mouse Club, and I love the Mickey Mouse Club at that time, and to be able to have met them and in a capacity as a peer, know, it's really cool. I don't get too starstruck. The only time I'd probably get starstruck is if
if you look at the mirror.
No. Angelina Jolie. I would die. If I could ever work with her, I would love that. And
Me too.
Angelina and Lauryn Hill. Oh, El Boogie, you got my heart, Lauryn.
Got it.
How about you? No, you can't say me because that's not real. Go ahead.
That counts. That totally counts.
Okay.
Let's leave it at that. Last one. Okay. Favorite advice you like to say to aspiring actors?
Just follow your heart, and no matter what obstacles that are in your way, like if there's a will, there's a way. There will always be a way. Sometimes things take priority, like, you know, and life happens, just life happens. And it doesn't mean to say that the things that you want won't come back and like slap you from behind when you're not ready for it. You know, but that's the good, those are the best things when you're not, when you're just surprised by things. How about you? What kind of sage advice would you have to any aspiring creatives or CPAs?
I mean, I think all I gotta say is, you know, if you have follow your passion.
Mm-hmm.
I think just in general, if you're passionate about something, it'll just come natural to you, and you'll be really good at it. And then from there, I mean, I think people will search for you, and people will, money will follow it regardless. If you have the passion for what you do and it's something that you love, don't do it for the money. Do it because you like to do it, for sure.
Law of attraction. I like that.
That's yeah.
Really good.
Mm-hmm.
But if you like money and you want to do it for money, I won't judge that either.
true. But
and if you want to send out your kids to be, YouTube artists or famous people, then that's okay too. Hey, Ryan,
do what you gotta do. Do what you gotta do.
All right, that wraps up this episode of our Q&A chat. Thank you everyone for joining us tonight, and thank you Kumu for supporting us.
And we want to thank you for selling out our San Francisco premiere this Friday night. It's amazing. And I'll be there. Check out lumpia.com for more screening dates and updates.
Yep. And everyone out there, do come back next Monday when another pair from the cast crew go on live for a Q&A chat. But it's not going to be better than mine this time.
No way. Yeah, so I mean, I guess we'll just skip it and just rewatch this over and over again.
Just keep doing that, and you know, we're not gonna be any more happier or lives changed. Because honestly, I don't know how I'll be able to get to this link after the fact, because I type like this on a typewriter. But I do thank you for typing in and chatting with us and joining us, Shaka. And thank you, Hawaii, again. Thank you for all your support always. Thank you, Francis.
Yeah, thank you, Joy. It was a pleasure. And hey, guys, definitely check out the screening. And remember, love that lumpia. So
love it.
Love it. All right, see you guys.
10.
I feel like it's, I have like,
little
I don't know what to do with my
Kabusta Kababai and Core. Oh my sexy for noise tonight.
No more!
No!
Hold on. Nobody messes with my family!
You're my hero!
No, man!
It's too Filipino!
What? For real?
American!
Kamusta kababayan ko? Oh, my sexy panoys and panays.
Welcome to Fogtown, where over 60% of the population is Filipino.
Can you confirm that the restaurant incident is the work of the so-called taquito man?
What?
This is the taquito everyone is talking about. It's not a taquito.
It's lumpia, the Filipino egg roll.
The motives of the lumpia man are still unknown.
Lumpia Man knows we're selling out Fogtown High.
What did I tell you about these kids?
Love that.
Lumpia!
And love that.
Lumpia!
Your sniper took down the mayor as
plan.
My henchmen are trained to be 100% efficient.
Is that the Admiral, man?
Nah, it ain't him.
Go, 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 go! Hey, hey, you can't eat that!
Remember me? You're my hero!
Now's not the time to change the plan.
What plan?
What the?
Please tell me you're a good guy.
It's too Filipino.
It's like soy sauce and salsa.
Getting messy.
All merged together in harmony.
Screw your mama's wedding.
Fight the bully.
You're all wrong.
It's all because of this damn Lupia man.
It took this long for me to find you. I'm not about to lose you, baby. You can be sure I love you forever.
No more. Fogtown will remember me. Taquito boy.